The Philistines, who were great warriors, had marched into the land of Israel. The army of Israel marched out to meet them. Led by King Saul, the army of Israel made camp on a hill across the valley from the hill where the Philistines were camped. And soldiers from both armies sharpened their spears before the battle and polished their armor. A loud rumbling sound filled the valley. A giant Philistine soldier, nearly 10 feet tall, walked slowly across the valley toward the army of Israel. He wore a brass helmet and brass armor. In one hand, he carried a brass shield, and in the other, a spear made of brass. The giant's name was Goliath. He stood in the middle of the valley and cried out, "Soldiers of Israel, men of Saul, our armies need not fight. Choose a man and send him here to fight me. If he kills me, we shall be your servants. If I kill him, you shall be our servant." Every morning and every night, Goliath came out and repeated his challenge. But when the Israelites heard the words of the Philistine, they were very much afraid, and not one man in the army dared to meet him. Near the valley where the two armies were camped, a shepherd boy named David tended his father's sheep. His older brothers were soldiers in King Saul's army. And as David watched the sheep, he played his harp and dreamed of being a soldier too.
David the shepherd tended his sheep day after day after day. He played his harp and sang the song to pass the time away.
"I'd rather be a soldier than a shepherd, a soldier in the army of the king. I'd rather hear the sound of marching feet than ba 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 bleat bleat bleat. I'd rather be a soldier than a shepherd, and someday I am going off to fight. Then the only time that I'll count sheep is when I go to sleep at night." Soldier than a shepherd, and someday I am going off to fight. Then the only time that I'll count sheep is when I go to sleep at night."
David's heart was filled with joy when one day his father told him to leave his sheep and take food to his brothers in King Saul's army. He found his brothers and they stood talking. Goliath came out and repeated his challenge. All were afraid, except David, who asked, "Who is this man who challenges the army of the living God?" David's oldest brother replied angrily, "You have left your sheep and come here only to watch the battle. Now go home." But instead, David went to another part of the camp and asked again, "Who is this man who challenges the army of the living God?" And the soldiers all answered, "Go home." And then David went to King Saul and said, I will fight the Philistine. But you're only a boy, answered the king. Once while I was tending my father's sheep, said David, I killed a lion. Another time, I killed a bear. The Lord who protected me from them will save me from the Philistine. And King Saul said, go and fight him, and the Lord be with you. He dressed David in his own armor, but it was so heavy that David could hardly walk. He took it off, went down the hill toward the valley, and from a brook, he picked up 5 smooth stones. 4 of them he put in his shepherd's bag. The 5th he put into a sling which he carried in his hand.
Bump, bump, bump. David's heart did thump as he walked out all alone to meet the great Goliath with a sling and a small round stone. Clang, clang, clang. How the echoes rang when the giant with his shield and in his mighty armor walked upon the battlefield. Zing, zing, zing. David twirled his sling, twirled it high above his head, then sent the stone a-flying, and across the field it sped. Whir, 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 just a speeding blur, flew the stone toward David's bow. Between the eyes it hit him, and he fell dead from the blow. Bump, 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 David's heart did thump when he saw that he alone had killed a great Goliath with a sling and a small round stone.
As the army of Israel cheered, David ran to Goliath and with the Philistine's own sword cut off the giant's head. And when the Philistines saw this, they fled. Saul's army ran after them and drove them from the land of Israel. And David the shepherd boy was hailed as a great hero, for killing Goliath was like killing 10,000 enemy soldiers. The people shouted, Saul has killed his 1,000, and David his 10,000.